Arriving at the salon is a bride on the hunt for a gown to match her personality.
My name is Marlene McCohen. I would describe myself as eccentric and shocking sometimes. I want like a big princess ball gown, but I want to incorporate feathers somehow. I don't care how.
Okay.
And if you wear with a feather, I'm going to carry a big egg with me.
Dad, it's about my birds. I've had birds since I was a kid, and I just love them. They actually communicate with you and talk to you and know their name.
I'm George. George.
If you came over to my house and met my bird, you would become a bird lover too.
Have you shot before?
I went to one store in New York.
Okay.
I tried on a black dress.
Okay.
No. I don't want the whole focus of the wedding on some crazy ass dress. I don't want the guests to say, oh my God, did you see what she's wearing?
I want them to say that. Okay. When I said black, it was more about being different. I want it to be like, whoa. Whoa.
Okay.
Hi, beautiful.
Okay.
I know you're not seeing black.
I know.
This has a black sash and it's a princess gown.
I don't like it.
We have feathers.
Okay, those are a no.
What?
Because I don't want anything that doesn't like poof out really big.
So these aren't poofy enough?
They have no clue what I want. It is already off to a bad start. You listen to feathers, you listen to black, and you focused on that, and that's not really what it's about. So I can't go looking at the dresses to give you guys like a better idea, because I feel like it's not even
close. Okay, yeah. If you want to, yeah. Normally we don't take a bride shopping, but Marlene seems to have a very clear vision of what she wants.
This is the dress I've been walking by, and I like,
So do you like this dress?
I just really like the lace. I feel like it's the classic princess dress.
I'm just getting scared.
I'm getting heart palpitations thinking she's gonna come out in this black dress that I'm gonna hate.
Oh my God.
And then I'm shocked because she comes out in this beautiful dress that's exactly what I want.
I love it. I think it's beautiful on her. I love the lace.
Yeah, but see how you're all like content. Like, I feel like you'd get over it in 2 seconds. I really, really love the way I look in this dress, but I feel like I would be selling out all my ideas of being different and eccentric.
You know what? I have an idea. I'm gonna go grab something. I'll be right back.
I think it's like, oh my God, perfect.
Really?
I don't know what's going to top this off. I have no idea. No.
That raises my blood pressure right now. Oh, please. In that black veil, it looks like a corpse bride.
It's like you're going to bury somebody. And most likely me if she walked down the aisle with that.
That is such a good idea.
Do you feel that this is the dress to beat?
Like, what about it is like, oh my God, like nobody else has it. I love the veil. I think it would be so much fun, but it's missing an eccentricity factor.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go.
Ellie greets Angelina, who has a unique look in mind for her wedding day.
I really want to look like a vintage bohemian goddess.
So I pulled a couple of bazaars in. One of them's a brand new one that we just got. It's got this funky bohemian feeling.
Oh, the happy face?
I love that dress.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh my God. Oh my God, I love this dress.
Oh, good.
I love the detail. I love the lace. I love the tulle. I don't even think I've ever seen anything that beautiful in real life before.
I see myself walking down the aisle in this dress.
It's really important that my guests love my dress because I love them and they want them to love my dress.
I don't like it.
Wait a minute. Time out.
What? I am completely devastated.
I don't like the tulle.
I don't like that thing going on the bottom. I think you were looking for a lot more layers and texture, and that's not it.
Okay.
You wanted the truth.
But I love this dress.
Marlene took charge of her appointment by handpicking a Daniela Caprese gown. But even with the addition of a black veil, it wasn't unique enough.
Like, what about it is like, oh my God, like nobody else has it.
So now it's on to a Pnina Tornai ball gown with a textured skirt.
I like the way the bottom has a little bit of a feathered look.
Okay. What do we think?
I like the feathered look, but I feel like this waistline's higher.
It
so
is.
It's not like as flattering. I'm really interested to see what they think.
So this is Pnina Tornai.
Nope. I don't think it compliments her in any way.
I think you look heavy in it.
Whoa! That would be the worst thing you could say to any bride or any woman on the planet.
Okay, it reminds me of a snowman. Like,
but a this, fat yes. snowman. Yeah, okay, I'm putting the pieces here together.
I feel like the actual pumpkin carriage that pulls up in the fairy tale.
What do you say, Marlene?
I don't like it.
Okay.
But like, look at those. Don't they look more glamorous at just looking at one of those? Like, I need to see what my eyes are already seeing.
Do you want to walk over there and pick out what you like? Okay, let's head right here.
Marlene's taking charge again.
I feel like this is kind of like a princess dress. This dress is beautiful. I mean, it's silver, it's fluffy, it's a ball gown. There's just so many things about it that, you know, I've been looking for. I want to try it, let's try it. It's really, really princessy.
What do you think?
How do you feel?
I love this dress. It's like silver on top. It's got a feathery feel to it. This is the dress that looks like I could step out of a carriage.
What do you guys think?
I don't know. I'm actually don't know what to say.
Like, do you like it or do you, like, why is everyone quiet?
I prefer the first one.
I think mom should just be happy the dress is not black. I feel like this dress is different. I love it. I don't care what anybody else thinks.
I think this is the one you love, and the other one I see another person wearing, which is not what you want.
Could you see yourself getting married in this dress?
Yes.
Guys, are you on board?
I'm on board.
Mom, what do you think?
I'm in love with the first dress, but when she wants something, she's gonna get it, and she's gonna convince me that she's getting it.
I can live with the silver.
Marlene, are you saying yes to the dress?
Yes.
Yes!
Congratulations.
At least it's not black or feathers, Mom, right?
Marlene stood her ground and said yes to her perfect fairy tale Pnina Tornai gown for $10,800.
This dress is way over budget, but I don't care. We'll cut people from the guest list.
Ellie sees if any of her other choices can top Angelina's favorite.
This is more of a slim A-line. No, this is a brand new gown. No, this is a beautiful lace.
Oh, I love that.
Angelina agrees to try this lace Marissa dress.
I still need more.
More?
I think I need, yeah. I think it's just I can't stop thinking about the volume and that that first dress.
Yeah. So, Angelina, do you feel like we want to revisit that dress again?
Yeah. This is my dress. I really hope they'll love it because of the way I love it.
Well, let's see what the ladies say.
Please love my dress.
I see that she loves it, so I love it. I'm happy for her because she likes it.
It looks beautiful on you, Ange. I love it.
The most important thing is that I wanted her to feel perfect in it. And I think she feels that way.
Are you saying yes to the dress?
I'm saying yes to the dress.
Yay! Hug your beautiful girl.
Sticking to her guns, Angelina says yes to this $3,600 Lazaro mermaid with lace appliques.